My voice wasn't on. Here we go. Okay, no sound, no sound. Okay, we got sound. Okay, there we go. Sorry. Good to see everyone. Good to see everyone. I can see it coming in now. Let's see till somebody says sound. Good, there we go. Okay, so I've been I have allergies right now. I've been thinking that a couple years ago I had people call in on the channel. I had a Google phone number, but then I didn't use it for a while, and people were calling it, leaving messages and everything. It was kind of a pain, so I gave it up. So I was thinking, I started on this thing called Clubhouse. Anybody know Clubhouse? It's a new social media platform. It's basically like a live podcast. The other night I went on with Tim Pierce and Rhett, and some other people came on. And what you do is you sign up, you follow people, and then you can bring on whoever you want. Like, I saw somebody post that Elon Musk is going to be on at 10 o'clock on his thing. I don't follow him on there, but what's up, Leo? But the thing is that I could bring people on from here, cause it's kind of like Discord, and I could bring people on from here and then you could talk. And if I'm holding the phone right here, right in front of my microphone, which is right here, I could hear you. And, wait, hold on. Do you want Friday filled up 10 and Thursday? No. Hold on 1 second. No, I meant, hold on, one on Tuesday. Let's see here. I'm trying to get my hair cut. My friend Charlene's texting me here. Let's see here. Hold on. I know it's funny, right? That I'm trying to get to do my let's see here. Okay, she's texting me here. Anyways, Leo, I know haircut. I gotta get a haircut. I'm trying to work on a video course and I don't want to start it. I've been not wanting to start it because when I get my hair cut, I'll shoot the first couple things and then all of a sudden my hair's shorter. Anyway, so 2:45 on Wednesday. Let me see if that works here. Sorry about this. Let me tell you. So Wednesday 2:45. Yes. Okay. Anyways, so Clubhouse, the thing about Clubhouse is that you can bring people on and off. It doesn't save the stuff, and it could be a way that we could, it could be a way that I could bring you guys on. To talk, where you're not calling in on this, you're not doing that, you know, and it's just audio only. But it can be where I can be on camera here, but you guys can be talking and you'll hear me. Although that might be confusing because it'll be delayed. I don't know. I have to think about it. But you guys should follow me. If you have Clubhouse, follow me on Clubhouse. Like I said, so the other night I went on with Tim Pierce. And then Rhett, I pinged Rhett. He came on. Then my friend Camilo, who's a great guitar player. Thank you, Fraser. Appreciate that. My friend Camilo came on. He was on for a little bit. Jake Ottman, who's one of my best friends. He's the A&R guy for RCA Records. he was on, and we were all talking at the same time. So it's a cool, it's an interesting thing. I mean, it's not anything I'm going to, you know, spend a lot of time on, but it's a way that, the way that I can talk to you guys, and it's the only way I could tell who you guys are, because if you sign up with your own name, because people use their own names, you would have to tell me who you are on here, right? Because not everybody uses their own names, obviously. So anyway, follow me on Clubhouse. I'll use it occasionally. I think it's kind of a, it's kind of an interesting thing. It's like a spur of the moment podcast that you can just get on anytime, and kind of like this, but it's all audio. You just use your phone. So this is just a way that we could do it here, where we could, or even if I stopped doing the live stream here and just went to Clubhouse, to the Clubhouse app, we could talk. I could bring people on, you know. I don't know. I'm thinking of, I'm trying to figure out a way. Thank you, Nathaniel. I've been trying to think of a way that we can get some voice interaction on here without having a Google phone number. That's the only limitation on this, on the platform here. The YouTube is the best, because the live, the having the stream here is great, right? So the stream is great, because you guys can text, but you can't talk. Like if Green Arrow were on here, you know, which he is on here. If he wanted to come on, DJ Green Arrow, and talk, he could do that. Of course, he could just call me and we could talk. I guess you could do that on Zoom. I don't know if it's just for the iPhone, Leo. I honestly have no idea. What's up, Rob? Good to see you. Everything's good. Discord would be perfect for this. Is that right? The Born Endeavor? Okay. Rigby had a Discord server. Okay, so maybe that's the way to do it then. I mean, Dylan is the one that he's on Discord all the time with his friends. I mean, that's just... Oh, wait. Check out Plynet, at Plynet from Chattanooga. Okay, check it out. So, yeah. So, maybe Discord server. But I think that that was a, that would be an improvement. The chat is great. So DJ Green Arrow, so he said, the thing about Clubhouse, it doesn't record, which is interesting. Yes, yeah, so Clubhouse can only be used on Apple. Did not know that. Rhett has a Discord server. I did not know that. But anyways, you guys, for those of you that have Clubhouse, you should follow me on there, because I'll get on, you know, with people like Tim Pierce, you know, or whoever, and my friends, have discussions, and people that come on, it's fun. I'm not gonna do it very often, but I like that it's audio only. So let me tell you about some of the stuff that I'm doing. What's up, Abel? Discord is great. Collective Soul update. No Collective Soul update right now. I've written to Ed a couple times. Nothing. You know, and I don't. I used to see Ed, this is years ago, when I worked at Tree Sound here in Atlanta. Ed would come in there. I mean, on it, this is like when Collective Soul was doing records all the time. Ed would come on and do, you know, he would come in and do, he would track stuff. So he'd come in and track drums and go home and do his vocals there, or do overdubs. And I would see him, you know, and we'd hang, whatever. But I mean, I haven't, last session I did a Tree was 2005. So it's been, God, 16 years now. It's amazing. Eddie Kramer update. Yeah. See, this is the stuff. I really need to, I need an administrative assistant, honestly, is what I need. I need to hire an administrative assistant. I actually talked to my friend Danny, who's runs a music program here in town, that Ken, my old assistant, well, you know Ken, you guys have seen him in my videos, GL. Ken it teaches audio engineering at this university here in Atlanta, one day a week. And so I was talking to Danny today because they have a social media program there, right? They have a social media degree program, and I told him I'm thinking about getting an administrative assistant or something like that, maybe part-time, because this is a perfect example right there of why. What's up, Rick? What happened to Brian? You mean Billy? Billy's still here. But Billy is not, that's not Billy's thing. He's not, Billy does other stuff. I need somebody that, I just have too much stuff going on right now. Okay, like this interview with Kurt Rosenwinkel. Kurt texted me 5 days ago. Hey, Deb, good to see you. So he texted me about 5 days ago. I texted him back, but I didn't follow up to talk to him. So I've known Kurt for, I don't know, a couple of years maybe. And we talked about doing a video together, and we just never have done it. And the Eddie Kramer thing, I just don't think. The only time I think about Eddie Kramer is when I come on here and somebody asks me, "Hey, how's the Eddie Kramer video coming?" And honestly, it's just having time. The hardest thing on really, so we have a new puppy and we have two new kittens. So we have three cats and two dogs now. And making videos, working on all this stuff, it's just it's really it's just time consuming. I haven't I'm doing an interview tomorrow with Chris Jericho, the wrestler, my old friend, who I have not seen in years. So I was getting ready for that, going over all his, closer moves and everything. It's gonna be that's gonna be fun because Chris is the Jericho's is probably the greatest music trivia person. He's one of the best that I know. Oh my God, he is amazing with trivia about any genre of music. So, but that happened, fast. We talked about it on Friday, and it's happening tomorrow. But these are, but these things, just organizing that, because I want to start. I want to get my, my podcast going again. I mean, I have a podcast. If you look up in the if you go to Apple or Spotify and you look up "Sounding Off" Rick Beato, you'll see my podcast. Anybody, open up another tab right now. Go to Spotify or Apple Music and look up "Sounding Off" Rick Beato, or just look up Rick Beato and see if my podcast comes up. Look up in podcasts. Because I want to be doing more just audio podcasts in addition, because I don't think that video podcasts, I don't think video interviews are that interesting. I think that people would like to consume those, unless someone's playing something like Tim Pierce when he played in the first one of the ones we did. It's in Spotify. Yeah, see, it's in Spotify. It's in the Apple Podcast thing. Found it, just subscribe. There we go. See that? You guys had no idea that I had a podcast. And I've had it since 2018. But I never tell anyone because I never think of it. This is why I need an administrative assistant. Somebody that actually can do this kind of stuff. I just... AP, thank you. Thanks for the channels. Always enjoy information knowledge you deliver. You're very welcome. Anyways, the audio is more engaging. See, Deb, the thing is that Deb says the audio is more engaging for certain things. If you're talking, you know, some of the people that that I talk to, like Jericho tomorrow, you know what I mean? That's going to be a video, but why does that need to be on video? That could just as easily be an audio podcast, right? If it's going to be something where somebody's demonstrating something, it's different. If you're in the same room, that's different. And it's safer to listen to podcasts when driving. Exactly. Whoever just said that. Chopper, you're right. It is. Anyway, so I just like to get that off the ground, my podcast. Even though I have 200 episodes, they're the audio of my videos. What I want to do is I want to have the podcast. I want to rebrand the podcast, take those videos down and have a proper podcast where it's where the video is recorded up close and things like that. To me, that's more, you know, where it sounds like a podcast. The audio version of your podcast, Dave, okay, has always been 5 to 10 times more popular than the same interviews with video. Exactly. Yeah, that's exactly right. That's exactly right. So I think that these, you know, there's so many people that I've talked to about interviewing that I could interview that would be great on a podcast. That would be easier for them to do a podcast. So I want to develop it. I'm not stopping anything with music or with YouTube or anything. No, nothing. Nothing's changing. Just I want to add the podcast. I want to add the podcast. Actually, develop the podcast more, even though I've had it for 3 years. Ethan keeps asking me about Dylan. How is he? Is he interested in music at all? Well, not really. You could do that with your uglier guests. look, podcasts are just different. They're just different. People that listen to podcasts, there's plenty of people that listen to podcasts that don't ever go on YouTube, but most people go on YouTube. That's the thing. You just need a media person, Brian says. Well, that's what this would be. Somebody that I need somebody. I was talking to my buddy Chris today. And he said, administrative assistant, so somebody that knows social media, that can do spreadsheets, that has a marketing or PR background, somebody that can email people. I don't want just anybody writing to Eddie Kramer. I've talked to Eddie on the phone. I want somebody that I trust interfacing with people to schedule stuff. I mean, honestly, that's what it is. And it's just, you know, it's tough. I just don't have the bandwidth to do it. I don't know if you've noticed it, but I've been making more videos now. I've been trying to put a video out every 2 days. And I've been doing a lot more of my original, you know, old school content. I did the video about losing perfect pitch. Yeah, then I did a video on modes, the live stream on modes, where it's more advanced stuff. Let's see here. Is the podcast on Amazon? I think it is. The podcast is pretty much everywhere, Johnny. This is my second channel. Have I ever played a drum solo? Not in a video, I haven't. I played the drum solo many times. Ethan, your consistency is amazing. I admire your work ethic, and you inspire me to make lots of music. Leo says it'd be great to do a full podcast with long conversations with musicians, not limited to usual length of a YouTube video. What's up, Subi? It is my first channel. Okay, so how long it what is the perfect length for a podcast? I want to get everyone's opinion on here. 260 people on here. What is the perfect length for a podcast? Is there's a new YouTube algorithm? 90 minutes, hour to an hour and a half. I think it's an hour myself. I want to see what everyone else thinks. 1 hour, 30 minutes, 45, 2 hours, 90 minutes. Okay, so I'll tell you, 40 minutes tops. Okay, the thing I like about th there's 30-minute podcasts to me are 30 or 45. Okay, so I like that. I'll tell you why, because I've been on a few podcasts recently. I was with Leo Sidran on his podcast this past week, and I'm not sure how long the let me see here. I'm not sure how long we were, but it was like so Third Story. Let's see here. I'm going to look and see. See if it gives a length for the podcast. Taking a while to. Okay. Let's see here. Listen on iTunes. Let's see here. Open iTunes podcasts. 1 hour and 7 minutes. Okay. So 1 hour and 7 minutes. I think 30, 40 minutes is good. Yeah, that's what I think I'm gonna do. yeah, most podcasts do chit chat at the beginning. I don't really chit chat. I'm not a chit chatter. Green Arrow says, I think you have to find what works. You've been experimenting with taking a long 3 to 4 hour interview, editing it, and splitting up into 30-minute chunks, putting them out daily for branding purposes. Rodney Mills was on Everyone Loves Guitar for 3 hours. Man, I haven't seen Rodney in years. Rodney's a great dude. He's a great dude. You know, a lot of people do. If I had a podcast, I'd probably do a sponsored thing or something. I might do that. That's something that people expect. Say the thing at the beginning, but then get right into it. Do an introduction and get right into it. But I have so many people that I could be doing that I could be doing a podcast with. So, anyways, that's anything. So I started out, for those of you that just joined, talking about joining Clubhouse and following me there. It's an app. Clubhouse is an app. I guess it's only for Apple, somebody said. I'm really surprised at that. Follow me on Clubhouse. I'm not going to sponsor anything cheap, Three Card Monty. No way. Come on. I would sponsor something that I actually would believe in. The like that experience. That's pretty good, Leo. I like that. Anyhow, there's people I could get on the podcast that wouldn't come on and do video, for sure. Gianni, what's up? Let's see. You wanted to ask a question, opinion on Stevie Ray Vaughan. What I think about his music, his technique. If I ever saw him live, never saw Stevie Ray live, but he was amazing. He's just ridiculous. Ridiculous. It was a sad day when he died. I remember it. Oh, it's awful. Is Beato TV on hiatus? Beato TV will happen this year, but later in the year, probably. Something like that. I'm trying to. I am. What is my wrestling ring name? Oh my God. I'm going to quiz Jericho tomorrow on some old school championship wrestling from the 70s, like Ernie Ladd and Johnny Powers, people like that, when I was growing up. I'm going to see how much he knows about that. That'll be fun. When they used to do, they'd have the guys that, Johnny A or whatever, they wouldn't even have complete last names. And we'd call them the scrubs. Right? They just guys that would come in, they'd lose the all the time. Bruno Sammartino, exactly. Superstar Billy Graham, that's it. I loved championship wrestling when I was a kid. It was amazing. Bobo Brazil, right. Oh my God. The Sheik. Yeah. Oh yeah, this is great. Chief J Strongbow. Oh yeah. No, it's so great, right? Johnny A, seriously, he's an awesome guitarist. No, these were I gotta look up what some of these scrubs would be called. They'd always have these like Ernie Ladd was definitely one of the ones who was, I think he was a former pro football player. He was a bad guy. The Iron Claw, George Animal. Oh yeah, this is great. This is really, these guys are kind of pre-Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant, but Andre the Giant was in there too. Thank you, Tim. Appreciate that. Hacksaw Jim Dugan. Exactly. That's awesome. Oh my God. This is hilarious. You guys know these Bach Backlund, yeah. Wow. Abdul the Butcher was one of them. I got to go back. I'm sure all these things are on. Pre-MRI, most of them are dead. I got to go back in and a superstar Billy Graham, Dick the Bruiser. Yes. Oh yeah. I've got to go back in and watch some of these things. Rowdy Roddy Piper, there you go. These are the old school. Does anyone remember Johnny Powers though? Johnny Powers was a wrestler. He had this thing called the power lock. It was a leg lock, and everybody would, that he got in it, that was the end of it. It's probably before everyone's time here. Mark says, 8 minute access. At least we know most people are over 40 here. I know, right? Oh my God. That is hilarious. Oh, Captain Lou Albano. That's right. Oh my God. I forgot. Lou Albano. He was a great. Oh my God. He was a wrestler, then he became manager. Deb, it's amazing, right? Axe Baby, the Heart Punch. Oh, the Heart Punch was one of the greatest. Really, was one of the greatest ending moves. The Bushwhackers, right? Johnny Powers. Oh my God, Paul, you know Johnny Powers? Finally, somebody knows Johnny Powers. Captain Lou was Cyndi Lauper's manager. That's right. Oh my God. The Undertaker. Yep. Rick Banhammer Beato. That would probably be it. That's my wrestling name. I should ask Jericho what my wrestling name should be, even though he is... Leo's like, what's going on here? Please talk scales. The Claw. That was another one, right? That's right. Oh, my God. Okay, you got this is great because you guys got me... You got me ready for the Jericho thing. So Jericho, though, his knowledge of rock trivia is unbelievable. He has a show on Octane, which is, I don't know if you guys know Octane. It's kind of the, it's the active rock station on Sirius XM. He's really knowledgeable about that. Anyways. Okay, so... I want to go back real quick and then we'll move on to music. I want to go back to Clubhouse. Follow me on Clubhouse. Hey, Michelle, you guys can I'll get on there and do some audio. It's like audio podcast basically, but you can bring people on. I can bring you guys on. That'd be a way to bring you guys on where you can talk and ask questions, whatever. Whatever. I'm trying to figure out a way, but I'm going to look into the Discord server thing, too, and see how that works. What is active rock? Active rock is I talked about it in my video on the Y2K curse. Active rock is a format that started up. I mean, it was kind of around, I think, in the early 90s, even late 80s. But it's... bands like Slipknot would be an active rock band or anything heavy, you know, any heavy band would be on there. System of a Down, active rock. You guys know what active rock would be. Just any type of heavy rock is active rock. Whereas you wouldn't play... Led Zeppelin would not be an active rock band. So heavy music without being metal. Yeah, although I think Octane does play metal. Disturbed would be active rock, yeah. Rage... Rage would kind of be active rock, I guess. Rush would not be active rock. Rush would be classic rock. So, anyways, active rock became the dominant radio format beginning in 1999, really. By 99, by the time you had Kid Rock, Linkin Park... Limp Bizkit, Korn, those were all active rock bands. Breaking Benjamin was an active rock band. So the active rock was really kind of the death of alternative music, though. Saliva, POD, anything post-grunge. Ray Baseman just said that, after grunge, that's correct. Anything, anything that's Slipknot, that would be all active rock. System of a Down, yes, exactly. So I'm going to be doing my 100th What Makes a Song Great. I think, I'm not sure about this week. I have an interview with Adam Franklin from Swerve Driver, one of my all-time favorite bands. Then I'm going to put out this week. I have a video coming out tomorrow on my favorite music YouTube video. I'm going to make a video about my favorite music video on YouTube. So you will, that's the next video you're going to see of me. So title, please. I'm not giving you a title. Let's see here. Yes, I did. So I got Adam Franklin. Oh my God. Not only did I have Adam Franklin, but when I talked about the alternate tunings that Swerve Driver did, I said, Adam, could you show me, take a tune like Duel, which is off their Mescalhead record, and show me the, kind of just go over the opening guitar part on it. And I said, and he sent me a video with like a tutorial of the whole thing. It was amazing. Oh my God. A tutorial of the whole song. And, yeah, so that I'm really excited about that. But the video I'm putting out tomorrow, I'm not done with it yet, but I will be, I should be done with it, is on my favorite music YouTube video. And you guys have no idea what it is, but it came out a long time ago. It's an old YouTube video. It's really cool. So, yeah, so that's that. So that's coming up next. So I got that. I've got the Adam Franklin video coming out this week. Jericho video, that'll probably be out the next week. And I talked about in the beginning of the chat about looking for an administrative assistant here in Atlanta. That's kind of a new thing to, because when I get on here, everybody reminds me of the stuff that I say that I'm going to do. Oh, what makes a song great this week? Yeah, that's going to happen this week too. Everybody reminds me of the stuff that I'm supposed to be, that I was going to talk about, or, you know, like, or that I was going to interview Eddie Kramer, people like that. And then I forget to do it. Okay. So, I'm going to play a couple things here. I want to play a couple songs and see if things get blocked here. Okay. That's one of the reasons I came on tonight. Let me see here. Browse. Here we go. Does Rick have Parkinson's? Jeff asks. I do not have Parkinson's. I shake my leg a lot. So no. I've always done that. I'm gonna play you. Let me see here. Artists. Let me see something here. There's a particular it's not even on here. Swerve Driver song that I want to put in my video with Adam, and it's from a record that is not released. It's not on here. And I'm hoping I don't have any problems with it. Let me see. See all. It's not even on here. Ah, oh, man. They did a record that is is my studio still active? No, my studio's not still active. Yeah, okay. And it's not even on, it's not even in iTunes. Oh, sucks. Bummed me out here. Let's see here. Let me try Spotify. I asked Adam about this, why it's not out there, and I forget what he said now. Let's see here. Swerve Driver. And I figured before I put out the thing, they don't have it on here. Okay, well, I talked about a particular song, about Adam's guitar part in a particular song, and it is on YouTube. Well, let me just play it from YouTube then. Okay, here we go. Okay, here it is. Okay, wait, that's not the song. Hold on, it's this song. Yeah, here it is. It's I Am Superman, Swerve Driver. Same record, though. I want to see if this gets a what happens here. Because this is a great verse part that I talked about. Okay, so that I wanted to see. I talked with him about the verse on that song, about the progression in it, and I wanted to see if I played it on here, since they don't allow it on, since it's not on YouTube or it's not on Spotify or Apple Music. I didn't know if there was something with the licensing of it, and if it was, if it would affect the. If it would affect the video at all before I put a clip of that in. The thing I hate, thank you, Austin. Thoughts on the Growlers, Tame Impala, and similar things. I am going to be doing some more indie rock videos coming up this year. So, just some thoughts on 2021 here. So I made the video. I've made a lot of videos on the grunge era. I have not made a lot of videos on 80s metal. So that's one thing that I've kind of, that I feel like there's a hole in the channel on. And then obviously music from 2000 to 2010 and music from 2010 to 2021. Those are things I want to focus on this year. I want to fill in 80s metal. Obviously, I want to go back and you do some more jazz content, even though people don't like it. More modern classical composition things, like I did in my live stream the other day on Modes. And I want to talk about music of the 21st century. So that's going to be a focus. I am going to talk about punk this year too, Brian, for sure. So 80s metal and punk, I've not talked a lot about indie rock, and I am going to do an indie rock video. I'm going to do an indie rock Spotify video, contemporary indie rock. But there's indie rock has really evolved over the indie rock has evolved over the last 30 years or so. If I think about Liz Phair, for example, okay, I loved Liz Phair. Or Sebadoh, bands like that back in the 80s and 90s, I just there's so many great, I don't know why this will not open here, so many great indie rock bands, and I love indie rock. Dinosaur Jr., things that were, and then you talk, I see here, El Scorcho talks about Band of Horses, Fleet Foxes, Animal Collective. So, that would be stuff that goes back to the mid 2000s to the present, and talking about that. So yeah, I'm gonna definitely get into that. Well, I talk about Motley Crue. So I did a video with Vince Neil, okay, that I always forget I did. There's two MTV or VH1 videos that I did. I did a thing with Desmond Child and Vince Neil where I'm in it. It was on VH1 like 200 times back in the early 2000s. And I worked with Flickrstick back in 2000 when they were on Bands on the Run, or 2001, honestly. That was, and I've never made a video about that. And I want to make a video about that. Let's see here, indie. I'm trying to find indie rock charts here. I don't know where these charts are kind of charts are kind of weird on Instagram. I can't I or on Spotify. I can't remember where they are, where they put them. Okay, so I'm gonna play something here now because I just because I was listening to this record earlier. This is Alan Holdsworth. I kind of started going back on a little Alan Holdsworth phase. This is just insane. I found a video where my daughter Lennon sings this song here, sings the melody. Listen, this is Vinny Caliuta playing drums. I know we're jumping all over the place, but my God, listen to what Holdsworth plays here. Okay, all right. When I interviewed Vinny a few years ago, the first time I'd seen him since 2005 or so, we talked about this tune and about that opening line, and he said it's like a rocket taking off, right? called City Nights. Oh, great feel. So that song was actually written by Gary Husband, who played drums on a lot of, you know, most of Alan's records. And it's interesting that Gary doesn't play on this, yet he wrote that song. And it's a beautiful song. I just love that. And I tagged Gary when my daughter Lennon, I did a video on Instagram. Oh God, it was probably 2 years ago or so. I need to repost it. And I played City Nights and I tagged Gary on it. And I interviewed Gary. He's a great guy. Just phenomenal drummer and phenomenal keyboardist. Plays keyboards with John McLaughlin. So Gary was very touched that Lennon sang the melody with that. That's so great. I need to repost that. It's fun. But that's a great, great record, Secrets, which came out in 1989. I love that record. Alan, absolutely brilliant stuff. Jimmy Johnson on the bass, you know. Man. It's honestly, it's hard to believe that that Alan's gone. And it's been, you know, it's been years at this point, right? I go back and I look at these records and I see, you know, that, I mean, that's it, you know? These records are not going to be out anymore. And the first, you know, I knew about Alan in the 70s when I, UK, Jean-Luc Ponty. But, you know, you know, if even you just go back to the first track on IOU. This is from his first real record. 1982. When I look at the edge, oh, it scares me. Oh. almost 40 years old. So the, you know, Gary told me that they had recorded the record in 1980 and it came out in 82. That's Gary Husband on the drums on that. So that record is 40 years old. Really, that's... Man. Hmm. That really makes me depressed, I gotta say. Sad. I don't know about depressed. I don't really get depressed, but it makes me sad. It really does. Alan was such a tragic figure, you know? I mean, he I was fortunate to meet him a number of times. And was always self-effacing, never liked his playing, never. Anytime I've met him, I talked to him before gigs, after gigs, but he was just an unhappy guy, I guess. I mean, I'm not sure how to say it, but that's an IOU record. So one of the first times I saw Alan play live was at the Red Creek in Rochester. I'm sure I've told this story before, but I'll tell it again. People didn't know what Alan looked like. It's not like he had the internet back then, right? So in order to know, you'd have to look on the back of album covers or look in magazines. But it was hard to know even, you know, anyway, so people are getting there for the gig. The band is set up and everything. Obviously, it's sound checked. So I noticed, I was like, oh, my God, that's... I might have been with my brother John or something. I said, that's Holdsworth sitting at the bar. And I went over and I talked to him. And he was so nice. It was before the gig. He was sitting drinking a beer at the bar before the gig. The Red Creek was this, I'd say 400 cap room in Rochester. Maybe 400, 350, something like that. It's over near the Rochester Institute of Technology. Used to be. I don't think it's even around anymore. But it was really exciting. I had had that record. It just came out. It was 82. They were on a tour. They're playing clubs, you know. I mean, they're playing bars, honestly. Bars and not even, you know, they weren't playing theaters or anything. It was just an exciting time. And I got a cassette of it somewhere. I have to go find it, but I definitely have some Holdsworth. All my friends taped bootlegged gigs back then, always. I definitely have some Holdsworth bootlegs from back in the day. But yeah, 82. I mean, it just seems like it's like a lifetime ago, you know, when I think back to it. My God, 40 years ago. So that was an IOU record. I mean, that, you know, there these records. Joshua, that's right, says back then you had to recognize musicians by their sound. Yes, right? Oh my God. Danny, you met Holdsworth, nearly identical situation. My friend Pat just called me, Pat Ryan, and Pat said that, so in 2014, he was at something in New York City with his daughter. He went into this place to eat in Midtown Manhattan, 2014. So, you know, 7 years ago. And all of a sudden, Holdsworth was sitting at the bar again and eating. And so Pat went over and talked to him. And Pat introduced Alan to his daughter, Pippa. And then Alan invited him to the show. And but what are the chances in New York City that Pat goes into a place to eat and there's Alan Holdsworth? And he has a picture on his Facebook page with he and Alan from then. Yeah, it's unbelievable. I see Rick live. I'm transported here. It sure was a lifetime ago. That's right, Bob. It was a lifetime ago. Let's see. Eamon, I saw the musical box Genesis tribute, some incredibly hardworking musicians. So those guys on the musical box, I went to see them when they were in Atlanta. The keyboard player wrote to me, follows my channel, and he said that they were in town. This is probably a year and a half ago. And I went out, I had met a couple of guys, went and had dinner, and then I went to their sound check. Oh my God, for those of you who don't know the musical box, they're a phenomenal, I think they're Canadian, Genesis tribute band. And they use all original gear. Oh my God. It was unbelievable. It was like seeing Genesis, honestly. They nailed the sounds though. It's unbelievable. Very, very cool. But that's like as close as you'll ever get to seeing Genesis, you know, at this point. To see Genesis of that era. Sam, you see I've regrown my sideburns. So my sideburns are like part of why I need my hair cut. Because my hair is way too long here and stuff, right? I just haven't had a cut and I've gone about 2 weeks too long this time. Thank you, Austin. Millennial guitar player here. There you go. Doom classic. Rap snitches. Knitches. Nice. Nazareth lead singer also follows my channel. Excellent. Gabriel Genesis or both? Both. You know, I was going to get the Clippers. David, you said get the Clippers. I have the Clippers, but the last time I did it, I screwed up and I cut a chunk out of my hair right there. And Charlene, who's been cutting my hair for, oh my God, since 1995, she's like, don't do that again. Just leave it and we'll get it sorted. Don't try that. I did it there and then I was trimming back here and I did the same thing. I totally just kind of screwed it up in the back. So anyways, I remember the Flowbee, Tim. Right, the Flowbee. I need a Flowbee. Oh my God, I know people that had Flowbees. No, I'm serious. You have to go with it when you have a guard and everything. You have to kind of go one way, but I have clippers and everything. But I usually trim my sideburns though. I usually just use scissors and everything. But Charlene tells me I should just wait and she'll fix them. But she told me to go right here with my sideburns. Don't go down to here. Go to here in the middle of the ear. She said it looks more natural. Anyways, what do I think of Warren Haynes? I love Warren Haynes. Oh my God. So good. Great, great, great. Great guitar player, great singer. Anyways, all right, I gotta go. I gotta return a couple phone calls here that I've gotten while I've been on here. You guys are the best. Keep an eye out for some of the new stuff, new videos. My video tomorrow, my favorite music YouTube video. I'm going to play it and talk about it. It's unreal. So, we'll talk to you guys later. See you.